Bomma le botate, molokoloko wa dirutegi o tla tsena mo nakwaneng ye kopana. Le gopelwa go ema.
Dames en here, die akademiese prosesie sal nou in beweeg. U word versoek om asseblief op te staan.
Ladies and gentlemen, the academic procession will now enter. You are kindly requested to stand.
By virtue of the authority entrusted to me, I hereby constitute this assembly as a legal congregation of the University of Pretoria. During this assembly, degrees with all the associated rights and privileges will be conferred to the candidates whose names appear in this program. Please be seated. Ladies and gentlemen, we request you to join us in a silent prayer or meditation to give thanks for the achievements of our students. Thank you. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to this autumn graduation ceremony of the Gordon Institute of Business Science at the University of Pretoria. Since the pandemic gripped us in 2020, our graduations were virtual, as we all know. And today marks the first of our face-to-face graduations. Just to remind ourselves that we are still under the threat of multiple variants. And for that reason, I will be brief and curtail my motivational address to our graduates. We usually speak for a very long time here until you don't listen. But today I'll be very brief. It's a great privilege indeed for me to officiate at this auspicious event. And during this season, 39 autumn graduation ceremonies at the University of Pretoria, 39, and this will be over the next month, a total of 10,847 degrees will be conferred and 1,169 certificates awarded. It has become a proud tradition of the University of Pretoria to kick off its graduation season with two ceremonies from GIPS. You see how we prioritize and how special you are to us. And the first of these took place this morning, officiated by the Vice Chancellor. And during the proceedings this afternoon, 268 postgraduate degree certificates will be conferred on our worthy GIPS graduates. And among these are two doctorates. Graduation ceremonies are always an inspiring and uplifting experience. And that's a loaded statement. We can talk for 10 minutes about that. They provide us an opportunity as a university and as academics and students, and especially people that have been supporting our graduates, to celebrate the hard-earned achievements and success. This is particularly true for postgraduate qualifications, such as the ones we celebrate this afternoon. As an academic institution, the University of Pretoria is proud of its reputation for producing socially impactful research to find solutions for the world's most pressing issues. And it may interest you that the University of Pretoria produces the highest number of research outputs locally. That means we're a big deal. And as this has been recorded by the Department of Higher Education, so we didn't just thumbsack it or bring it to ourselves. It's credible information. We also continue to improve on the quality of our research. And UP, of course, is one of the biggest contributors of qualified professionals and research students in the country. GIPS is a very distinctive part of the University of Pretoria. And it is here at the University of Pretoria, at this Hartfield campus, as far back as 1949, you know, 1949 became a home of our first MBA outside the United States of America. Don't be jealous. I know it was during apartheid, but it was still the University of Pretoria, 1949, first MBA outside the United States of America. And it is here that the business school has grown from strength to strength. And as we look back at the proud academic tradition, we simultaneously continue to look forward in the hope to fulfill the needs of society by molding the really competent leaders of tomorrow. And I'm addressing this to you, Mr. Dean. And part of the underlying philosophy at GIPS is that the ability to lead and manage complex organizations in a volatile environment we face is a key driver of African prosperity and growth. And a while back, our very own now, Professor Adrian Seville, we used to listen to him on the radio with Andile and Power FM all the time, like, who's this guy? until I realized he teaches at Gibbs. He noted that South Africa's reality is that our environment is far more diverse than many others, and for this reason, our business training needs need to be relevant to that diversity. And with this context, Gibbs has become a preeminent producer of world-class graduates that are sought after in the industry, whose career progression is worth following, and who make a significant difference on the continent and across the globe. And today, our Gibbs MBA continues to be ranked among the top 100 ranking globally. And I mean globally, top 100, it is a big deal. Because remember, there are so many business schools in this world. Some are fly by night. They still produce whatever it is they produce there. So little wonder then that Gibbs is one of the precious jewels on the crown of the University of Pretoria. And to you now, our graduates, today you can truly be proud of your academic qualification as we celebrate your success with those who supported you in your academic and professional journey. As you walk across the stage as part of the rites and rituals of the graduation, I trust you are not only more educated, you're well-rounded and effective leader than when you first arrived at Gibbs. You have the skills that have been honed and a deepened ethical foundation, but that you have during your time at Gibbs has also built a very valuable networks for you and us, precious friends, happy memories that will last a lifetime, and may you forever be loyal as alumni of UP, and remember to give back to your institution whenever possible. That means if you make money, think of us. And for all this hard work, I would like to thank the Dean, the Deputy Dean, and the directors, as well as your teachers, everyone else that has been involved in this, including the administration of the University of Pretoria, for making sure that you have a seamless journey towards your graduation at the University of Pretoria. It must have been a rewarding experience. And for that reason, I thank you. And I will now request the Dean to introduce to me the candidates present whose names appear in the program.
Mr. Vice Principal, forgive me for going off script and begin by greeting. Ladies and gentlemen, and all genders in between, good afternoon and welcome. And staying still off script, because this is only our second graduation and we're still a bit rusty, I would like to remind the graduates that as you arrive on stage, you please pass me your name ticket. You stand here on this mat. You look up for your picture to be taken. And so this is a demonstration, Dr. Ya. I'm not yet calling you. So when you quietly, maybe you can reverse and pretend this has not happened. Stand on the mat as beautifully as Dr. Ya did recently. You look at the camera, I read out your name, you wait for somebody to wave at you, and then kindly go to the vice principal who will cap you, and then you'll move on to the next very important people. And please remember to respect social distancing. Do not try to kiss anyone. Do not try to shake hands with anyone. But remember to smile and enjoy the moment. Going back to the script, Mr. Vice Principal, the supervisors will now introduce the doctoral candidates, beginning with Professor Helena Barnard and then with Professor Alette Erasmus.
Mr. Vice Principal, I introduce to you Yaa Afi Usai, who has complied with the requirements for the degree Doctor of Philosophy with a thesis titled The Role of Demand-Side Factors in Financial Inclusion in Ghana, prepared under the supervision of Dr. W.K. Durban and myself as co-supervisor. In her thesis, the promovenda assessed two demand-side barriers, financial literacy as a skill and self-efficacy as an attitude, to combat barriers confronting involuntarily financially excluded individuals. The study used a pre-post intervention quasi-experimental approach with data for 6 months. Participants from four communities received training in either financial literacy, self-efficacy, or both or neither. The results showed that regardless of whether participants received training or not, they did not use their bank accounts for transactions or savings, although their financial knowledge and skills for financial decision-making did improve. An analysis of the results showed that local economic structures and the level of formal economic engagement influenced the uptake of formal financial services. As a result, financial inclusion should not be promoted as a single strategy, but as part of a broader development and social inclusion strategy. Mr. Vice Principal, I request you to confer the degree on the candidate.
I hereby confer the degree, Doctor of Philosophy, with all its associated rights and privileges on the candidate.
Mr. Chancellor, I introduce to you Doa Sorgdrager, who has complied with the requirements for the degree Philosophy Doctor with a thesis titled The Interplay of Visual and Auditory Cues, Telepresence Customization and Product Information on South African Millennials' Online Sensory Experiences and Clothing Purchase Intentions. It was prepared under my supervision. In his thesis, the promovendus focused on millennials in the emerging South African market. He specifically attended to their purchase behavior when performing a real-time shopping exercise when using a custom-designed mobile phone application that was designed for a fictitious clothing retailer. Using the stimulus organism response framework, he examined the relationships between selected sensory cues, sensory experience and purchase intentions, also attending to the moderating role of telepresence, customization and product information. The findings confirmed positive relationships among all the constructs in his conceptual model, except for product information. The study provides valuable insight on how millennials' online clothing purchase endeavors could be enhanced, and provides practical insights for clothing retailers to improve consumers' online sensory experiences, and how online sales could be boosted through more effective mobile phone app design. Mr. Chancellor, I request you confer the degree on the candidate.
I hereby confer the degree, Doctor of Philosophy, with all its associated rights and privileges on the candidate.
Mr. Vice Principal, having the knowledge of how hard it is to get a PhD, I would request the whole House please give those two a big round of applause. Mr. Vice Principal, the following candidates have complied with all the requirements for the degree of Master of Business Administration. Amit Abraham, with an award in Digitization Strategy and Technology. Chesre Abrahams, Stacy Allers, Devlin Anderson, Fennel Anthony, Carl Baumeister, Carlo Bondesio, remember to get capped, with an award for the Global Award for this top student in the Global Module, Willem Boshoff, Quentin Boyens, with an award in decision making for the highest overall mark. If you can wait for me to call out your name, thank you. We'll get there. Bianca Branford. Don't worry, Bianca, we're all nervous. James Britton. Clive Brooks, Ayanda Buteles, with an award in strategy in private equity, and with distinction, Robert Catania, bear with me, with an award in business opportunities and innovations in Africa, as well as an award in corporate governance, Gwenth Chanakira, with an award in turnaround management, Andrew Chapman, with an award in Environment of Business, Darren Chetty. Thank you. No problem. Please face the Vice Principal when you are receiving and wait for me to read out your name, ma'am. Just wait. Just talking to everybody else who's still coming. Please face the Vice Principal to be capped and then wait for me to read out your name in case I'm waiting because there's a delay on the other side. Thank you so much, Laneshri. Laneshri Chetty. Thank you so much. Shingai Chiviru. Thank you. Lizelle Craig. Bear with me, with an award for negotiations and deal making, as well as an award for tech entrepreneurship, and graduating with distinction, John Peter Kritikos. Roberto De Silva. Skalk Deval. Egmont Donation. Okay. Truly bear with me. With an award in entrepreneurial marketing and an award in innovation and design, and an award in tech disruption, and with distinction, Mr. Ferdinand Dippenaar. Breaking the flow, congratulations, Njabulo Dlamini. Matthias Durrow. And with a nice phonetic card, Karsim Ferkir. Congratulations. Congratulations. Jean-Pierre Faury. Joash Gabriel. With an award in business valuations and deal structures, Shivaji Gadhavi. Unati Gama. Glynis Gannis. And with an award in advanced entrepreneurship, Quillen Gavender. And with an award in customer-centric strategy, Anne Gray. With an award in Emerging Technologies and the Future of Business, Nilius Grief. Annelisa Guadiso. With an award in Creativity and Ideation, Chantel Hadfield. Asha Haribai. Thank you. May He. Thanks for the coaching.
Thank you.
Elaine Holmes. Mike James. With an award in dynamic innovation, Nishal Joggi. Katlego Kekana. Zintle Khoza. Matshepo Kwape. Johannes Koorts.
Hello, congratulations.
Karabo Lekhotwane. Congratulations. Lerato Lekema. Sekila Lengau. Rato Lepale. Nozipho Madlala. Kagiso Mafache. Nicola Magede. Motlacho Makhato. Rofiwa Makova. Kolodi Makola. More of that, please. Sunduka Makumbani. Just wait. Wait. Tsepo Malike. Nabil Malik. Eugenia Mampi. Patricia Mankai. Ritsedisitswe Maphala. Congratulations. Megan Marimoto. Congratulations. Christopher Martin. Christopher Martinez. Not Christopher, but John Maruma. Muzigayise Masina. Mpho Masisi. Congratulations. Nolulama Matutu. Sinazo Mazwi. Sandisiwe Meso. She's very popular. Let's see how much you get, Nicholas. Nicholas Mayer. Let's keep it going. Sintu Mhlonyane. With an award in persuasion and the art of science of influence. And with an award in new venture creation and with distinction, David Malowitzki. Lesnar Mystery. Sihle Mkhize. Andiswa Mlisa. With an award in Mindful Leader, Khumutso Modise. Malefetsane Modupe. Khaulatle Mueng. Kevin Mokgale. Harold Mokgale. Congratulations. Sibong Musa Mugiba. Keletso Mukabane. Give that lady some water. Elgin Mukwatle. Congratulations. Maloko Mulife. And with an award in trade in Africa, Tato Muloi. Lebohang Moloto. And with an award in integrated business simulation, let me read your name. Thank you. Sashen Mudli. Mwako Muremi. Kavish Motilal. Kholofelo Mothopeng. Khumotsegang Mothwa. Zibusiso Moyo. Fungai Mukaratirwa. I will first read your award and then your name. With an award in operalizing strategy, Mpho Munyai. Teboho Mushi. Sybil Musundi. George Mwamlowe. Hendrik Myburg. Musenga Mukosa. With an award in corporate innovation and entrepreneurship, Antronika Naidu. Caroline Naidu. Patience, please. With an award in social entrepreneurship and measuring impact, as well as an award for multinational enterprise business strategy. We stop there, right? Mugendran Naidu. Keeping up the Naidus. With an award in business technology enablement, Neil Naidu. Pumza Nakani. Thank you. Congratulations. Lorraine Ngube. Congratulations. Babalwa Ndunge. Ndashe Ndiamba. Sam Ngaka. Thank you. Mochanyara Ngandu. Noluvo Ngewabe. I'm going to take off my mask because I'm running out of air. Start again. Rebecca Nkhudi. Nande Ngoloba. Grab some water, take a few pictures. It's on me. Thank you. Thank you, Renelwe. We'll send you a special arrangement. Renelwe Ntswarang. This is Prof. Benedel's award. With an award in geopolitics and grand strategy, Koliwe Ntshonta. Musiwa Nyadzani. Tafadzwa Nyagano. very active on social media, Bongani Nyati. Busiso Nyoni. Patience, everyone. With an award in professional management consulting and an award in effectual intelligence for management consultants. We'll come back later for this one, but I'm going to name it anyway. And top student for the research project. And with distinction, Michael Olifir. At least you are arriving with an award. With an award in strategic finance and value creation, Olesigan Omuniwa. Congratulations. Samandri Pareachi. Congratulations. Chanel Pareachi. Cornelius Beattie. Okay, it's a water break. Yes, they're coming. Samuel Perumal. Kakamatso Patlani. Limpo Peko. Chrisanta Pele. Pravita, my apologies, Prativa Pele. Piyadashni Pele. Mushibudi Pitsi. Lerato Plaikis. Abigail Pretorius. With an award for effective execution and project management, Savas Raftopoulos. Valencia Raja. Mashiane Rakosa. Jaco Ramahali. Jesus. Abhinash Ramasari. Irvin Rambau. Congratulations. Zahir Randeri. With an award in strategy and general management, Jermaine Reddy. Surendran Reddy. With an award for effective execution and project management, Thabang Rapitswa. Naomi Ragpath. Aisha Sidat. Minister of Finance, Tito Sipolwane. Refilwe Sitsedi. Mluleki Shongwe. Nzwana Nai Shoniwa. This is a very hard one. Alexandra Sly. Hendrik Smit. Carlo Snaders. Ashmir Sukdeo. Jacqueline Swart. I got coaching. Nonneto Tony. Just in case you didn't hear it, Nonneto Tony. You're welcome to coach me. Notando Tonjeni. Refilwe Tsotsi. Rebecca Twala. Brandon Irwin. Werner van der Merwe. With an award for strategic implementation, and that's not easy. Congratulations. Congratulations. Daniel van Heerden. Robin Villagaz. Menicia Vilho. Okay, settle in. With an award for behavior science for business impact and an award for strategic leadership decision making, Amy Lee Williams. Samantha Williams. Annika Vormerans. John Zama. Abatendi Zwane. Stabile Zwane. Sfiso Ngwenya. Mr. Vice Principal, the following candidates have complied with all the requirements for the Master of Philosophy in Corporate Strategy. Joel Mbotai. Well, thank you. Congratulations. Wanda Dlamini. Pumeza Ferreira. Vasigi Jagdesi, with an award for strategic management, my course. Gladman Kala. Sija Kekana. Thank you, congratulations. Nadira Lari. Tamanda Longwe. Ribotile Malaka Laka. And an award for Best MPhil Corporate Strategy Research Project, Ella Manana. Ayanda Manunga. Akona Mazwi. Ngaba Mkwanazi, and with an award for leading through storytelling and an award for digital disruption. Congratulations. Mamukheti Mukwetsi. Tsulufelo Muliko. Lorato Moyo. Kholiwe Mtingane. Talent Muzimba. Nersia Muyanga. Seeing my students for the first time face to face, Prof. I've taught them online to do their MPhil. It's insane. Jayamuni Naidu. Ready? Shangilayo Ndadi. Janet Ndebele. Tenda Muzimu Nemusombori. Congratulations. Lamek Ngubozabo. Mavis Ntsane. Tandiwe Ntuli. Prageswari Pillay. With an award for women in leadership. Magdalene Rametse. Linda Rulashe. Congratulations, likewise. And one of my other favorite courses, with an award in environment of business, Ashor Sarupen. Matume Sikhala. With an award for diversity and inclusion, David Stanford. Settle in. With an award for strategic foresight, as well as an award for global business strategy, global economics, allow me to introduce Mohammed Taib. Sandra Tererai. Georgia Wilkins. Namhla Zondani. Mr. Vice Principal, the following candidates have complied with all the requirements for the degree of Master of Philosophy, International Business. Richard Cunliffe. With an award for Africa in 2050, betting on ourselves, Shaina Gokul. Grant Hendricks. Settle in. Okay, with an award in Women in Leadership, award in States and Markets in the Global Political Economy, award in International Business and Emerging Markets Award, as well as being the top research methodology student in MPhil in International Business, Aisha Isaac. Agbor Kande. Abram Khotle. Hendrik Latega. Halala Sianda Mango. Beautiful. Thank you. Ribone Moshala. Teboho Mukwele. Fezega Monakali. Sindiswa Nkulku. With an award in States and Markets in the Global Political Economy, Seipati Tso. Sanele Zondi. And this is a special student for me who graduated in 2021, and the specialness will stay with me, MBA part-time, Pheteni Nkuna. Mr. Vice Principal, I will now be presenting the following awards: an award for the top student, MBA, for the top student, MPhil in Corporate Strategy, for the top student, Master of Philosophy, and the top student for the Integrated Business Research Project. Beginning with the top student, MBA, as well as top student, maybe I should do them in turn. Let's have a look. Got both. Great. Top student for Masters of Business Administration, and top student MBA in Integrated Business Research Project, Michael Olefier, everybody. Off script, this is not an insignificant thing. Please stand up and give him a standing round of ovation. Michael, you have the singular honor of being the top MBA student in our first cohort of triple accredited MBA students. Congratulations. And the top student for the MPhil in Corporate Strategy goes to, she's not here yet. Is the other person here, and she is absent. Okay. Vasagi Jagdesi. She too is inaugural triple accredited. And then top student for MPhil in International Business, Karine van der Merwe. Also absent. Sadly, also absent. My job is done. Congratulations, everybody.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Dean.
Somebody's running. Let's see. Sorry, I thought Vasagi was here. That's what I thought. I thought, am I missing something? Ladies and gentlemen, the first cohort of triple accredited MPhil in Corporate Strategy, Vasagi Jagdesi. Stand up and give a round of applause, please. And my notes that Karine van der Merwe is absent are correct then. Thank you once again, Mr. Vice Principal.
Thank you. This is a celebration. We have given so many applauses, but I'm duty bound to ask again to give our graduates a big hand for the hard work and perseverance. And I know sometimes, but let me keep quiet. I'll confirm my suspicion. And I would like to ask our graduates to applaud their families, friends, and spouses for the support. My suspicion is confirmed. Even those who are not graduating did it. But that's cool. It's fine. Listen, gentlemen, we have come to the end of our proceedings this afternoon. And now we are requested to stand for the singing of the national anthem and to remain standing until the assembly has been dissolved and the academic procession has left the auditorium. And the words of the national anthem are printed on the inside back cover of the program for those who don't remember the words. Let us start singing the national anthem. Authority entrusted to me, I hereby dissolve this assembly of the University of Pretoria.